Hey guys, it's Morgan coming back to you with another install video and build video for the 2023 300XC. We are having so much fun with this motorcycle. If you haven't checked out the series, I've got a playlist built here on our channel all about this motorcycle. Make sure you go watch all the videos on it. I think they're really good. I hope they're super informative. I hope they're entertaining, all that good stuff. We've been having a bunch of fun riding it. We've got 3 days worth of riding, 5.5 hours on it so far. Lots more coming. We're racing it this coming weekend. So that's why I'm trying to get these build videos done quickly, because I want to protect this motorcycle and make sure I don't wad it up too bad racing it, because, you know, it happens. So we're here late tonight at the shop to get some more stuff done. Today we are going to be putting Bulletproof Designs radiator guards on this thing. There's a lot of questions, even from Bulletproof, as to whether or not they're going to fit. They sent me guards. I believe they will fit the radiators. Whether they fit with the shrouds and the pipe, we don't know. So we're going to find that out tonight. We're also going to be putting Bulletproof Designs levers on the bike, some of my favorite levers, and Enduro Engineering open flag handguards. So if that sounds like fun, you want to watch that happen, you want to hear me talk about this bike, then join us. Let's do it. All right, guys, so with the old school radiator shrouds that were not so tucked in, these things are so tucked in, with the old ones, you could put the radiator guards on without taking everything off. Not so on this one, but I'm also very excited to take the tank off. I haven't taken the tank off, so join me as we take the tank off this bike for the very first time. I've never done it. I'm not even 100% sure how it's gonna go. So, seat, loving this seat setup. So easy, so nice. One bolt, super simple. Got normal tank bolt here. Actions for the fuel system. So, I like this, it's right here. Very easy to get off. Fuel connector, it's right here. Boom, super simple. Now, gonna try to do this like I would the other ones. There he goes. All right, here we go. Never done this, let's see. There we go. Seems a little precarious, but haha, here we go. First time on film, tank off of the 2023. Let's take a look at some stuff. As you can see, everything is brand new. Head, cylinder, power valve cover, everything. Head stays, everything is brand new. Totally crazy. It is nuts. We can see right here, we got the master, we have the main fuse and starter solenoid right there. Battery, the lithium jobber. That's probably the relay to turn everything on, the power relay. Got a fuel pump, extra fuel pump fuse. Got places for the other relays for the fan. You know what? Why don't we put the fan on too? Let's do it. Let's see if the fan's gonna work, right? Because, I was told by Extreme Parts that it would. Let's find out. So, here's the ECU. Pull this. Boop. It comes out of the way pretty quick, which is nice. I don't know what that wire, what's that wire for? Ooh. What is that wire for? All right, guys, I was going to show you me installing those radiator guards, but I must have either not hit the record button, or it got corrupted, or, oh, it did. Actually, my camera fell and hit the ground. Now I remember. So, yeah, unfortunately, I did not get that. But those radiator guards go on exactly like every other Bulletproof Designs radiator guards. It's super helpful to get the tank out of the way and mount it. I also found out where that other wire went and talked about that. It goes to some sort of sensor or something. Maybe it's an ambient air temperature sensor. I'm not sure, but it's in kind of behind the air box. How about, anyway, whatever. It goes to a weird spot, but it's, I don't know. It's really hard to get to. So I left it in there. I was kind of hoping maybe it was like taillight wires that they just didn't talk about it. That's not the case. Anyway, the Bulletproof Designs guard is mounted right up. Just bolts come out of the old guards. They pop right off. New ones go. Anyway, it's super simple. Let's get back to the video. All right, guys. Upon further inspection, the Extreme Parts fan kit is not going to work yet. So let me show you something. I do have a wiring harness, a power that would bring power to it. So I could use like Trail Tech fan and all that would work just fine on it with the temp sensor. But it does not have the harness that then puts the relay here and all that good stuff. It comes with a relay. So if you had a W, this would work. It does not work yet. But I'm not giving up on it because someone out there has probably got a harness that works with this thing. So whatever, no big deal. I don't need a fan on it right now anyway. But yeah, we're gonna dig into that and figure out how to make that work. Just need to get a harness that has the plugs for the relay. And you know, it's gotta be, I don't know. I bet we can get one off of a W thing, because supposedly this bike is supposed to be able to do that. It's supposed to be able to have the capability to read temperature and all that stuff. So anyway, no big deal. Psyched on the radiator guards. Like really psyched that those fit. So yeah, let's button the back end of that thing up. And let's see, what was next? Gonna move to Bulletproof Designs levers next. It's time to put the Enduro Engineering flag handguards that I like on. These are super simple. It's just these guys, what do they call them? Open-ended moto guard. So there we go, there's our left one. Come in here, just take these bolts out. Gonna reuse the bolts. Gonna save this perch in case anything breaks. We're just gonna come down on top. Super simple. We gotta dig into our pack of stuff we got from KTM. Get the bolt. Comes with it. Line everything up. There we go. One thing I really like about these levers versus stock is the shape is good, whatever, that's fine. But when you adjust the lever for reach, it doesn't adjust the throw on the master. So as you bring this in, it doesn't really change. I mean, it does change the distance between this and the grip, so it's technically a little bit different, but it's not just moving the thing in and out on that pivot. So I really like that. I think I might move this inboard a little bit, but I like that a lot. Now I'm gonna put the other one on. It goes the same way, no big deal. I'm gonna get everything bolted up, show you what the thing looks like, and kind of go over all the things we've done so far and tell you what is coming next. All right, guys, I'm done for the night. I think we got everything on there that I wanted to get on there other than the fan. So we got our Enduro Engineering guards. I really, really love these things. They have been so strong, taking so many hits on my other bike. It's right over there. Love you, Daisy. Bulletproof Designs levers. Obviously, brake side. Looks great. Radiator guards. Let's take a look at those, might as well. Kind of hard to see tucked in there behind those super tight shrouds. Boom, looking good. And Bulletproof Designs chain guide brace or swing arm brace, swing arm. Anyway, that thing, it's awesome. So we are nearing the end of bolt-on parts on this thing for me. I don't run a pipe guard. And I'm going to run this skid plate. I am going to get the link guard from Bulletproof Designs. They actually are sending it to me right now, so we should have that very soon. The next stuff we're going to be doing is an RKTech head. I'm going to be taking this motor apart, guys, after a race weekend. Should have around 10 hours on it by the time we do that. So it should be interesting to see what that looks like inside, and then also get those measurements for deck height, squish, and all that stuff. And then suspension. Suspension will be the final thing. We are just slammed. I don't have time to take these things apart. Also, I got a race coming up. So hopefully, very soon in the next week or two, we'll be getting the suspension apart and getting our settings on that. I'm pretty sure we've got some settings that are going to work really good with these new forks and shock. So stay tuned to that. And also here very, very soon, I'm going to do one big long video going over everything we've done to it. And then we're going to weigh it and see what it comes in at with all the extra stuff. It was 238 pounds full of gas, bone stock. So make sure you write that down. We'll see what it ends up weighing when we get done. We're pretty close to bolting things on it. I think pretty much done, other than maybe a fan. I got to figure that out. But you know, whatever, that doesn't weigh much. We can figure that out. So anyway, hope you guys like that. Hope you get out, spread the gospel, two wheels. And I desperately hope that you get out and pop some wheelies.